Hello students, welcome to my channel. This is Osman Naik from Canada Engineering College. Today we are going to study an important topic, that is electronic mail. Electronic mail has got three components. One is SMTP, second one is POP3, and third one is IMAP. Now the full form of SMTP is Simple Mail Transfer Protocol. POP3 is Post Office Protocol, and IMAP is Internet Mail Access Protocol, or Internet Messaging Access Protocol. So, before proceeding, first we'll see what is SMTP. Then we'll move to POP3 and IMAP. Let's now discuss the three major components of electronic mail. One is user agent, second one is the mail server, third one is the Simple Mail Transfer Protocol. Now, what is the function of user agent? User agent will allow the user to compose the mail, edit the mail, and edit and read the mail. For example, if you have Outlook or Thunderbird or iPhone mail client, that can be used as a user agent. In the diagram, you can see here, three mail servers are there. All these three mail servers exchange mails by using Simple Mail Transfer Protocol. Other than that, user will use the user agent to send and receive mails, to compose mail, etc. Mail server contains mainly mailbox. The purpose of the mailbox is to store user mail. All user incoming mails or messages are stored in mailbox. Then all outgoing messages are stored in message queue. Other than that, SMTP protocol, that is used by both client mail server and receiver mail server, or client sending mail server as well as receiving mail server, to send the mail from one end to the other end. So a SMTP is a series of commands which authenticates and transfer messages from one server to the other server. SMTP mainly works based on TCP. TCP is nothing but a connection oriented protocol, transmission control protocol. It is nothing but a connection oriented protocol. When we say connection oriented protocol, that means it will establish a three-way handshake and transfer of message and closure of message. So SMTP makes use of TCP. That means the delivery of mail is guaranteed. In case if the mail is not delivered due to the improper address, then sender will get a notification regarding the failure of message. And one more thing is, SMTP makes use of port number 25 to transfer port number 25 to establish the connection between sender and receiver. So now we will see the one scenario where user Alice wants to send the message to one more user, Bob. So in the diagram, Alice composes the message by using user agent, which can be Microsoft Outlook or other softwares. And after that, the user will send the message. The same message will be stored in the user mail server. And from this mail server, that message is forwarded to the recipient mail server by using the protocol SMTP. By using the protocol SMTP, the mail messages will be transmitted from one server to the other server. Once it reaches the recipient mail server, the messages will be stored in a particular user's mailbox. Now the user, Bob, will log into the mail server by using either webmail or Outlook, Microsoft Outlook, or any other software that acts like a user agent, and he can download the mail and or he can view the mail by using webmail. In this diagram, you can see the format of the SMTP packet. SMTP packet format or message format contains like header and body. Header lines includes to, from, subject, and body of the message includes some ASCII characters depending on the message.
Now, to access the mail, receiver may use two types of protocol. The first one is called as POP or Post Office Protocol 3. Second one is called as Internet Mail Access Protocol. So, both protocol can be used by the user to download mail from the mail server to user machine or user inbox. So now, what is the difference between Post Office Protocol and Internet Mail Access Protocol? Post Office Protocol is very simple, but the problem with the Post Office Protocol is once it downloads the message, it will delete the original copy of the message from the mail server. It will delete the original copy of the message from the mail server. On the other hand, Internet Mail Access Protocol will not delete the original copy of the mail in the mail server. Along with that, on the other hand, Internet Mail Access Protocol has got several advantages. One advantage is it will not delete the original copy of the mail. Second one is it will synchronize the client machine with the latest update of the mail. For example, if the particular user is using his desktop machine at home, then that machine will be synchronized with the latest update. So IMAP has got several advantages over Post Office Protocol, but Post Office Protocol is simple. It will save the space on the server. So in this way, simple mail transfer protocol works.